In this video, I'll review a pull request of a student of the React Job Simulator. This page shows a list of issues. This list is paginated, which means it only shows some of the issues right away. The user needs to navigate to the next page of the list to see the next set of issues. The student's task here was to implement the filter at the top. The filter has three fields: two select inputs so the user can filter for a certain issue status and level, plus a text input that allows filtering for a project name. In this code review, we'll see that this filter component is tightly coupled to the pagination of the issue list. It's not easy to spot and the refactoring isn't huge, but removing unnecessary coupling in your code can have huge effects on maintainability in the long run. Anyway, let's have a look at the code. This is the code of the filter component you just saw on the website. The code looks solid. The component uses a custom hook that returns the filter values and allows updating them. For some reason, the project name filter is stored in a separate state variable, which is initialized with a value returned from the custom hook. The state is also updated by the use effect, specifically when the project name is empty. I'm not sure why this is necessary, but it's not the main concern of this review, so let's ignore it here. The filter inputs are wrapped in a form. There's a submit handler attached to the form. The handler updates the filter values by calling the functions returned by the custom hook. After updating the filter values, the navigate to page function is called. It sets the page to 1 and passes the new filter values. So it seems that this code is responsible for resetting the pagination to the first page of the issue list whenever the filter values change. Since the navigate to page function is a prop, this is where the filter component is coupled to its parent. Besides this function, there's nothing that connects the filter component to the pagination of the issue list. In fact, the filter component doesn't even need to know that it's used on a paginated page. So this navigate to page prop couples the filter component strongly to the implementation details of its parent. The idea of the following refactoring is that the resetting of the pagination should be the responsibility of the parent. This again will decouple the filter component from the rest of the page. The first step is to rename the prop. OnFilterChange is a much more neutral name that moves the responsibility for any action triggered by a filter change to the parent. The new name already suggests that we should only pass the filters to the OnFilterChange callback. So let's remove the new page param. Now we decoupled the pagination functionality from the filter updates in this component. It might look like a small change, but the filter component is now much more quote-unquote pure. We could use it now in other places that have nothing to do with pagination. My next suggestion is to group the filters in one object instead of splitting them into separate parameters. This way, it'll be much easier to add new filter parameters in the future. This change also enables another valuable refactoring. We can introduce a shared filter type that can be reused by other parts of the app. I added the type to the component file here, but I'd recommend moving it to a higher level. This way, it's obvious that it's a shared type and can be used by other parts of the app and different layers like the API requests as well. Finally, we need to adjust the parent component as well. In this case, it's the issue list component. The first change is to use the shared filter type. You can see that it's much neater, as we don't have to redefine the filters all over again. The last step is to adjust the props we pass to the filter component. We can't directly pass the navigate to page function anymore. Instead, we use an inline function that accepts the filters and passes them on to navigate to page along with a new page value of 1. Again, here we can see that we introduced a clear separation of concerns. The filter component is responsible for handling the filters, while the issue list component is responsible for any action after the filters are updated, like resetting the page to 1. I hope you enjoyed this small code review and refactoring session. This is going to be a video series of code reviews. If you're interested in getting a review of your own code, leave a comment with a screenshot of the code or a link to a GitHub repository or a pull request. And if you want to get hands-on experience on a production-grade code base and professional workflows, join the React Job Simulator. You can find a link in the description.